Watercolour frog painting tips and techniques is what this video is all about. I'm Paul Hopkinson, a wildlife artist and an online tutor. Welcome to my YouTube channel. After you've watched this video, take a look at all the other content I've got available on my channel, from complete tutorials to masses of tips, tricks and techniques. Now, as you will see, I love sharing my paintings of wildlife, furry, feathery and everything that grows in the ground as well. Now today I'm going to give you a very sneaky peek into a brand new video tutorial, which is all about a bright, vibrant, red-eyed tree frog. So what I'll do, I'll show you some footage from my real-time video tutorial and give you a little insight into what it's all about. Now for a little bit of fun, look out for some jumping frogs. Now these may point you some more content on certain techniques. Let's get the brushes wet and let's roll the video. Okay, so that's nice and dry. So I think what we'll do next, let's add a bit of a watery wash down on the legs and underneath the belly as well. And also this little leg down here. Now I'm looking very closely at that reference photograph by pinching into that, as I can see now. To do that, we need a little bit of colour, obviously. Cerulean blue on its own, or cerulean blue. And also alizarin crimson with phthalo blue. Both of these are to a watery mix, okay? So very watery. Just make sure that's nice and watery as well. In between doing this, I'm washing my brush out in a dirty pot and then in a clean pot. So I've got a twin pot, which is basically this here lot. There you go, see how dirty that is one side? I'll wash it in that one, dry it on some kitchen roll, then wash it again and dry it again on some kitchen roll. And I do that every single time I kind of wash the brush out. So just bear that in mind. Just worth noting, really. Because at least that way around, you'll end up with a nice clean brush when you go to the paper with clean water. Okay, let's just start adding the water in again as we did before. When you look at that photograph again, you can see underneath here it's more like a purpley hue, isn't it? And then as it comes down the leg, you still got that kind of hint of purple there. But then you go to like a cerulean blue, this really bright blue. And then that kind of phthalo blue or intense blue is another name for it as well, which is a Winsor & Newton brands. Phthalo blue being the professional watercolours and the intense blue being the student watercolours. But they are the same colour. Okay. So just wet that area down there as well. Okay. Let's go for the purpley mix first of all. Right underneath the old chin, just start around there, add in this basic wash. Remember, this is just that foundation wash again, nothing more. We don't want to go too dark too quick, at least that way. I'm just going to use a bit of water, by the way. That way, if you don't go too dark too quick, if you make a little mistake, a little happy accident, you can fix it, you know, you can sort it out, which is good. Okay, right around to there. And also I can see a little bit just before where this blue block is here. Just to there. A little bit more now underneath the chin. Okay. Now, well, tell you what, I can just see some more. See where this line comes down here, which I've very lightly drawn in. There's an area there, like a patch. There's a patch around here as well. Yeah, that'll do. Then go for the cerulean blue. And you want to use this now for the leg. Now there is a white area at the end here. So you can reserve that white just by going around the area like that. It's leaving a bit of a white gap. And then down to the leg. Adding this in. Because obviously when this is nice and dry, we can go back in with some of that deeper blue. Deeper. We just need this paler blue underneath. Look at that. Oh, lovely and rich, isn't it? Might make it a little bit thicker. And then down the forearm as well. So if we go for the ready black now, which is this colour, with a little bit of lamp black added to it, then we can go for the darkest areas next. So we'll start off at the very centre and go for the pupil. Oh, here we go. Now, you can reserve the white of the paper, as I mentioned as well. It's entirely your choice. Or you can just pop in a little bit of watercolour white when it's dry. Or a bit of white gouache, which is usually my preference. Because it's such a tiny, tiny highlight, isn't it, around there? Don't overload the brush. That's the key as well. So when you do load that brush up, all I simply do, look, I load it like that. I roll it, load it, roll it, and pull away. Okay? So if you think load it, roll it, and dab it on some kitchen roll as well, which I've just done, then that's the way to do it. So load it, roll it, dab it. And just consider the shape I can see. And the angle this is on as well. It's not completely 12 o'clock, 6 o'clock direction. It's more between 11 and 12 and 5 and 6. If you put a line straight through the middle of that. And that's what I'm looking at when I'm checking the photo to see where this goes. Now you got a bit of a circle there, which there is. There's a line going through said circle, barely touching the paper. That's so tiny. So tiny. A little bit more paint. I think I will use a little bit of watercolour white on there, actually, just to make it stand out a little bit more. So tiny area. You can, of course, do this bigger than this if you wanted to. So just get the rest of the dark areas on, and then we'll switch to some watercolour white in a minute. Or if you've got white gouache, that'd be just as good. Depends on, obviously, the make as well. So as long as it's kind of opaque in nature. Now, I'm going to really look carefully at the direction this goes in. Because we've got that sort of bluish highlight going around, which is this section here, I may still have to let that stand out a little bit more than that, yeah. You've got to remember that's there. So coming around the eye. You tend to find my hand, by the way, is always here because I'm always moving the paper around with my other hand. Which is why you probably wonder why my hand's always in shot, or very often in shot. That's the reason why. Now look at the shape as well for this eye. It's not completely round, is it? It's a bit stretched out. In the same direction as the pupil. Remember that between 11 and 12 and 5 and 6. The same axis is probably about the same on this as well. It should be the same. So I'm going to carry on with the rest of the blues. I'm going to work on this leg first of all. That's the most prominent one. So getting a little bit of cerulean blue. So something like that there. Look, to a creamy consistency. Put that back. And I want to add this into that really bright area down there. A little bit round here. We'll blend this in a minute. And anywhere else that's needed, probably around there maybe. A little bit more in that area. All ready for blending. A little bit around there. What about the bottom, the back leg? So I'll look at that one. Turn my paper around. Got a bit of water on there. So the back leg again. Just a little bit towards the back of that area, and maybe along that top. I do want to blend this. Clean brush, come back in, and start blending it with small circles. All you need to do. All kind of set in the background scene ready for when we add the darker blues over the top. And you know those blues now, you know what you got to do with those. Blending those in so you can't see where one colour starts and the other one finishes. A little bit around there as well, shaking your water off your brush. Gonna blend it up a little bit now, soften that edge just a touch with a damp clean brush. Okie dokie, right, happy with that. Or happy-ish anyway. Should never be completely happy with your painting, do you know that? Right, so now we've got to think about the blues over the top. Now, there's a bit of purple in there as well, but I'm going to go with the blues first of all. So the first one is the phthalo blue and the cerulean blue. I'm going to see where that starts around here. A bit too much on the brush there, Paul. A bit more purple around, so we'll leave gaps because there's purple in that area. Because we'll be filling some of those gaps in, not all of them. It's just outline. Said it again, didn't I? Just this top of the leg here a minute. Now I tend to bring my hand around to get that natural sort of movement from your hand. And just kind of ease off that line as you come towards the end there. The same will apply there. And that kind of hooks around. Kind of, well, it's uphill there, comes down in a slight dip, and then back up a little bit again. So it gets to this area and just kind of finishes around there, doesn't it? Now then, I can see quite a lot of sections in here, so I'm going to use little tiny blocks. So you can see I'm just making gradual patterns, so I'm basically sort of scumbling, but with the tip of the brush. Just creating patterns within the leg. All the way down. Don't worry about filling anything in just yet. Let's get these patterns on the paper first of all. Just squiggles really, aren't they? That's all they are. Playing with squiggles. Some more paint. Watch out for that water run. Small circles. Just to blend it. And then you can blend this as much as you need to go. So if you think, hang on, that's not blended enough, Paul. We need to add a little bit more in there. We can blend it even more. And whilst it's still wet, come back in again like I've just shown you on the other toe. A little bit more colour into that wet area. Allow it to flood in. Just on one side. Allow it to blend. Watch it happen. It's magic before your very eyes, it really is. And then the same on this toe. Or this toe. This end of the toe. Wet it. A bit more water, I think, in there. And then gently, very gently, mix those colours together. Or the colour together, should I say. Just so it's like that. And if you need to, a little bit more colour around the bottom area and let it blend. So that's two toes. Okay, now we're going to do the same. Just put a bit more colour there for the other toe as well. But you can see there's little areas in between, isn't there? So slightly dark. Let's just get some more paint. So when this leg comes down to here and you've got this line coming down, we've got this toe coming over. Really study that photograph and you see what I mean there. There's like a valley, like an intersection here where they all seem to kind of come together, one little area. It's actually darker in there as well. So I'm going to make sure we just add enough of this colour in to begin with. And then again, this toe comes around there. This toe, let's just extend that line around now. It's lighter on this edge, but we can lift paint off, remember. And this colour should lift quite well. And we'll do the same on this toe by increasing the colour. So I want to show you one of these feet, as I said, just so you got the idea on what to do. And the other feet, we'll just get some music on those, unless there's anything different, you know that. And then this toe here, coming around that side. Ooh, where's that knuckle go? Oh, I don't know. Oh, yeah. We've also got a bit of a area here where it kind of hooks over. Is that in the right place? Just about. Just to there. Increase it there. Increase it here. Looks like a shoehorn, doesn't it? Yes, I remember shoehorns. Okay. And then wet for the blank areas. And then small little circles to blend that colour in towards the middle. And the same, get some fresh water down there, give it a quick rinse for this area down here. A bit more colour, come back in and add that in. Watch out for the runs, add that in. Now I really do hope you enjoyed this frog watercolour video, and just to let you know that the full version of this is available on my online school. Now check out that learn more link down below and access all the free content as well by signing up on my website as a free member. I'll see you in my next video to my right, which goes into massive detail on how to paint really fine lines, which are ideal for adding those tiny highlights to the frog's feet. I'll see you there.